We meet the great yachtsman Dennis Connor in an interview that has its moments. And what did happen to Cursor Jensen? Good evening. That was how it started. As I sat there scared stiff that very first night, the first program, who could forget it? And of course, we all know what happened and how he reacted as Dennis Connor walked up. Well, 15 years later, we are still here. We're still strong and we're still doing the business with audience numbers, if you'll excuse my telling you, the highest they've been in 8 years. Welcome to our 15th anniversary special. April 3rd, 1989, we started. 1989. George Bush Sr. became president. The Swedish tourist Heidi Parkinen and Urban Hoglund went missing. David Longy resigned as prime minister. Sale of the Century was launched on New Zealand television. Ekitahuna lost its post office. Sister Mary Leo died. So did Laurence Olivier. 1989. The year United Flight 811 had its side blow out. It was the year the Berlin Wall came down. And Philippa Keane, our current executive producer, was sitting school certificate. Oh, but we were new and we were dangerous and we were shocking, yes. And the doubters were plenty. Oh, yes, indeed. A couple of the harshest critics have graciously agreed to make a comment or two 15 years on. Good evening to you. Tonight on Holmes, we meet the great yachtsman Dennis Connor in an interview that has its moments.
Magic.
In Auckland, we thought he was an upstart. This little guy comes up from Wellington, announces he's going to push us all over and conquer our universe, and he bloody well does.
But no, I didn't know if the show would continue.
I said that, you know, wouldn't last a year, he'd be doing ads for opticians by the end of the year.
I honestly thought that was going to be Paul's last year.
They warn you not to mess with dirty Dennis Connor, especially when he's hurting. Well, right now he is, and we did.
Cheeky bastard.
You chose to laugh at that, Mr. Connor. You chose to laugh at it and you put up a catamaran.
And he had this new style and he was, you know, in your face. He was opinionated.
Yeah, thank you very much for having me.
But would you be interested in apologising to Mr. Farr in public, Mr. Connor?
He walked off and the switchboard just lit up like a Christmas tree.
I thought this was a current affairs show and, you know, he was carrying on like Jerry Springer.
They said everything. He started off with a C, ended with an F, and kept on going through all the alphabet. We're never going to watch TV One again. We're not going to pay our license fee. He's a bastard. He's a prick.
Well, I thought some kind of apology was called for.
And then what did Mr. Holmes deliver to us the following night? The sexologist, Dr. Ruth.
You mean orgasm? Is orgasm important for both?
It's good that you are saying that, because God forbid if I would be known to say the word orgasm on New Zealand television.
Such is life.
15 years. If you come back to me in 15 years, I'll say exactly the same thing. He won't last.
Yes. Well, the numbers, he did look like a prick, really, didn't he? Yes, the numbers are impressive. In the 15 years, we've broadcast more than 3,500 shows, 14,000 stories and interviews, and 45 reporters over the years have worked on Holmes. We have been there with you for the big events, for the big issues, the big moments, for the sadnesses, for the good times, and, well, yes, we've upset a few people. As a matter of fact, we've upset an awful lot of people. We've helped many people. We've changed some people's lives forever. And we've travelled around the country, we've got out and about, and it's been, you know, when you look back at it, it has been such fun.
You had a body like this, like a god.
Australian judge.
What's your answer to that?
I actually have only one leopard skin outfit and that's it.
That bloody screw, that thingy. We'll have to do it again. Hang on.
Last time you put the rental car.
How are you? Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much for having me.
There, seen enough of it?
out.
No.
No.
Oh, big cuddle.
Beautiful hand, Susan.
Now, Paul, I hear he's got your nose. Is that right? I'm just trying to look up.
Yes, the doctor decided, yes, I think he's got the Holmes snoring. Wild thing.
Yes, there is issues. There's always an issue with the baby, so.
Just a moment. The Queen spoke to this.
She actually spoke to me.
Who leads a life of danger?
Daddy, have you got a weapon in there at all?
You're very good.
Very good?
You're very good at it.
You're so good.
No, you're better.
Your Excellency, wonderful to see you from Denmark. Your Excellency, Most Excellency from Egypt.
Silly, I ended up in mental health. Anyway.
Can Mr. Nehru see the King of Spain? No, he cannot.
The trouble with these musos, once they start, they never stop. Oh, here we find the master of the household.
Master of the house.
You've always made it absolutely clear that Peter runs the house.
Well, it's every New Zealand boy's dream, isn't it?
Your divorce.
I think I'm quite happy with it actually.
There is the destruction that remains of those rash World Trade Center towers.
It's all right for us to talk about it, but you've been assured a year ahead. You're in trouble, aren't you?
Yeah. I put my spirit to the
test. We have to finish this now, you know why?
Why?
Because if we go any longer, your sunglasses are going to come bang right down over your eyes.
Oh, that.
How much?
They don't mind a cue, the English.
$200,000 for this on top of a $30 million project for 8 birds.
I've known many birds as individuals for 15 years. Some of them have been through messy divorces. We followed those.
Oh.
Pardon me.
£200. That was a corner
jump.
Oh, Mr. Hairpin.
I've seen you somewhere before.
Yes.
Many.
Oh, my goodness me! Sayonara! Samurai!
I'm very proud of my son.
A special guest inside the show tonight, special visitor. Time to go home? Those were our people today. That's Holmes tonight.
Still to come on the program, those faces on the program, the reporters, our team who have told you your stories over 15 years.
Paul, a long time ago, Marshall McLuhan, even before your show started, Marshall McLuhan said we're only allowed to be famous for 15 minutes. Now, you've been famous for 15 years. 15 minutes of fame, that's four people are allowed to be famous every hour, times 24 hours of the day, times 365 days in the year, times 15 years means, goodness me, that you have kept 525,619 other people from being famous, which is roughly the population of the Waikato plus the Bay of Plenty.
Those are our people today. That's Megumi tonight.
Those were our people today. Was it?
Those were our people today and Mitchell's tonight. Or would you want it
simpler? That was Mitchell.
That was our... Those were our people today, and that is Mitchell tonight.
Ha ha ha!
Yes, the hair's changed a lot, and the glasses, of course. This is a pair I found the other day. These are from about 1993, I think. We call them the Joe 90 glasses. Can't do without them, especially the glasses. Now, names like Kerry-Ann Evans, Cameron Bennett, Susan Wood, of course, Susie, Liam Jury, Mike Valentine, Ian Sinclair, Jim Mora, Vicky Wilkinson-Baker, Rod Vaughan. These are some of the names you'll remember from our very first team, or those early teams, back in 1989. We were a very tight team then. We always have been, still are, but we were especially then, that small group of us, when Holmes first smashed onto the air in 1989. And since that day, 45 reporters have told your stories on this program.
15 years, well, if you'd said to me 15 years ago that I'd be standing here now, Paul, wishing you a happy retirement. Oh, no, it's not that. Okay. Well, no, congratulations on an ongoing career.
Can't touch this.
This is what they've come for. The music's called Happy Hardcore. Take a look.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
Small and friendly, and that's the way they like it.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
What makes a good neighbour? Well, not being nosy.
Can't touch this. My music hits me so hard, makes me say, oh my Lord, thank you for blessing me with a mind to rhyme. Touch this.
A person could go quite balmy, really, confronting the challenge of filling 3 minutes.
There was sort of a bit of black, and then he came back and started ad-libbing.
At prime time tonight, we foment revolution, call for the end of MMP, the restoration of the Bourbon monarchy.
And I think it was hilarious. It showed his comedy and his ability to make people laugh.
I pull around the world, from London to the Bay.
Paul was standing on a rock that day. You see, the thing about having your name on the marquee for 15 years is that you're either there because you know where all the bodies are buried or because you have a remarkable talent. He does have a remarkable talent. He's the big broadcaster of his generation. Well done, Paul, and here's to however many years more.
With your brother, with your mother, stand alive, stand alive.
Do you think teeth are important?
Yeah, I think they should be important.
Sounds pretty nasty, doesn't it? Mouth's pretty nasty in places too.
What I want you to do for me on that one is I want you to get it out and have a go.
This is too small.
Give it a go and see if you can actually get that baby working. Oh, not too bad.
Let me take you on a journey back 30 years. This is the
garden. Yeah, let's try and get it in sync here. You need to get a bit more spring.
Okay, yeah. Well, I'm not black.
Loosen up. You don't need to tell me that.
Because I didn't expect you to be, like, even this small. You know, I was expecting it to be little.
Oh, well, that's usually not the first question.
Hey! I can't help you.
I don't want nobody, baby. If I can't help you. Yet, incredibly, locals say they never suspected a thing. I don't want nobody, baby.
You'll see that.
Whoa!
It moves quite a bit.
He's gonna move! No, he's licking me! Get it off me! Please! Get it off!
Holmes as a program went on to redefine television current affairs in New Zealand, revolving as it did and does around the exceptional energy and talents of Paul Holmes. So congratulations, Paul, and the show.
Thank you, Cameron. Thank you, all of you. Still to come, more from the last 15 years on this Holmes 15th anniversary special.
Now, there's one more. One more calculation. If the show continues for another 6 years, 2 months, you'll completely silence Wellington, which, depending on your point of view, is either a tragedy or something to shoot for.
Those were our people today. That's Tolan tonight.
Those were our people today, and that's Osting tonight.
Those are our people today. It's Tosh tonight. A bit stronger. Those are our people today. It's Tosh tonight. That's okay. I go too many people watching today. That's Tosh tonight. Those are our people today. That's Tosh tonight.
There you go, 15 years, 15 long years of pouring out half an hour of television every night, and it's been hard work and it's been grueling work, and it's gone so quickly, it's gone like that. Where have the 15 years gone? So thank you for watching, thank you for your long support and for your loyalty. You've been here in the good times, but most importantly, you've been there in the bad times as well, and I've had a few of those. And you've stayed. Our people stayed. Thank you. We were a dedicated little team back in 1989. It's an entirely different team now. But there's one person who's been there all the way. That's my mum. Can you hear me, mum?
Yes, I can, Paul.
That's a change.
It is, isn't it? I even had to take a hearing aid out.
And this is a complete surprise. I didn't know they're doing this.
All right. You didn't. Well. Now, I've warned not to say anything to you if you rang. But anyway, Paul, I'm just here, half a kid in myself, to just congratulate you. 15 years is a long time. Ken and I are both very proud of you and love you. And
love you too, Mum.
Thank you, Paul.
And it's a very special weekend for you, I know, because we're coming to Hawke's Bay tomorrow for your 80th birthday party. You're 80 this weekend.
Oh, God, Paul, you shouldn't tell the world.
Well, there's something to be proud of.
That's very nice. I'm looking forward to seeing you all.
And you in Hastings, are you? Are you in Hastings?
I'm in Napier.
Napier, very good, yes. Mum. Well, you're looking wonderful. It's a beautiful brooch, the old butterfly brooch.
Hey, it's very nice, Paul.
And you're looking lovely. Your hair looks lovely. Everything, you look great.
Oh, good. I hope so.
Tell them. I thought they must have. I thought something was being jacked up, and I know you've not. Have you missed a show? You ever missed a program? Have you ever missed a program?
Not only if I've been away on holiday, and if I'm only away a few days. Excuse me, I video it, Paul.
Very nice, Mum.
But I haven't missed many.
Happy birthday,
Happy always
Mum.
Agreed with you, mind you, but I have watched them.
Good on you, Mum. We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you.
I'm
talking to a guest. Sorry. Thank you very much for your time, Mrs.
Well, I guess, Paul, that's me tonight.
That is you. Very well done tonight.
Okay, Paul.
We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, Mum.
Bye-bye.
Very nice.
Good.
You.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now, Mum. Cheeky.
Congratulations.
Great. This is the team. Here they are. This is the current team. That's fabulous.
We've got Kate. You can't do anything around here without Kate.
Oh, look, you better hold that up for the camera. Can the camera see that? Other way around, Madge. Other way around, Madge. And you still have to...
I'm the blonde one.
Can you hold it up like that?
It'll get on your suit.
It will get on the suit. Oh, God, be careful. There we go. Well, you probably can't see it too well, but it's got nice sort of 15 years and still groovy and dangerous. We're very groovy and dangerous. These are all very groovy, dangerous people, Mum. They will be a very bad influence tonight, Mother, I'm sure. But we'll see you fit and well tomorrow for the party. Look at you all.
Look at the t-shirts.
Look, groovy and slightly dangerous, this one over here. So, there you go. That's the current team. Are we wrapping it up now? Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for watching way back then. Thank you for still watching. We are still going strong. Those were our people over the past 15 years. That is Holmes at tonight. I knew we should have rehearsed that more. Thank you.
You're nobody till some.
That Holmes didn't take to him very well. I think he tried getting fired off the Herald. In fact, I know he did.
Somebody cares.
It was that usual mix of admiration and horror.
you know, if you only let the horror out, you hold the admiration in. I'm still holding it in. But
gold won't bring. I thought Holmes had 15 years in him. I think he's got another 15 years in him.
Well, I also predicted the downfall of Shortland Street, and that didn't turn out too well. Still is the same, you
never change it. Holmes has never looked better as a program. Holmes has never looked better as an individual.
Good luck to the man. You know, as I always sort of say, ka pai tō mahi, Paul. Love your work, boy. But